Two Dutchmen left standing in this competition alongside the great Raymond van Barneveld, a 4-2 victory over Wayne Jones. So look what's happened for you so far today. Mark Walsh through, went to a tiebreaker, 4-3 victory over Alan Tabern, who had 6 match points. Confirmation of that victory, Wayne Jones heading home, Vincent van der Voort through 4-2. Terry Jenkins, 7-time major finalist, taking on Steve Brown from Bristol. We're back. HD3, Sky Sports 3 from 7 o'clock. Really good lineup for you. Kick off the night, world number 15, Wes Newton takes on Brendan Dolan. Put out Kevin Painter, of course, in round 1. 2010 runner-up Simon Whitlock, world number 4, takes on the Heat, Dennis Ovens. And James Wade up against the Austrian World Cup star, Mensur Sulevic. Okay, up next, Terry Jenkins against Steve Brown, the rising star from Bristol. Eric's been to meet him.
Hi, Steve. Welcome back to Valley Pally, mate, after your little Christmas break. Great little win first round over Jelly Klassen. It's a tough little draw, that, really, because I know he's a fast player, but sometimes he sticks a few good legs together, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's difficult to play against because he's unpredictable. So, you've got one eye on his score when he's throwing because you don't know what he's going to hit.
Yeah, one minute he goes 45-45, and then he goes 180 out.
Exactly, yeah, and he'd done it to me a few times and punished me when I thought I was in the lead, and he banged a few 180s in and put me under pressure at the last minute.
And now you've got to get through the second round now. That's your next big trick, isn't it? There, today, obviously, you've got Jenkins, who you've played before. You kind of no fear against him, as you beat him on TV already.
No, I enjoy playing against Terry because it's quite easy. He's so consistent. You know he's going to hit 140s, so you've got to get your own 140 head on. It makes my job easier, really, so... In a silly way, but I'm looking forward to the game.
I mean, in the first round, none of the top 16 seeds went out, which is unknown. It's never happened before.
Yeah.
And the start of the second round, the first 4 games, 4 of 16 seeds went out. So they're all popping out in the second round, which looks good for you, really.
Yeah, it does, but I think you're going to see a big change, especially in the top 32 over the next 12 to 18 months. There's a lot of players like myself, we're hungry for it, and we're putting the hours in, and we're gaining the experience, and I think we're going to start taking these big boys on. There's no room for journeymen now in this game. I think you've got to earn your crust, and I think they can see it in our eyes that we want it. So, yeah, I think they're starting to fear us a little bit.
Well, best of luck today, mate.
Cheers.
I'll be talking to you later on in the week.
Thanks, Eric. Cheers.
Thank you, and welcome back to the action, coming to you live from the Alexandra Palace, London. It's the Ladbrokes.com World Darts Championship. Brought to you by the Professional Darts Corporation. Time now to meet our players. Time to meet the Bristol Bomber, Steve Brown!
Just because we get around.
Time to let loose the Raging Bull, Terry Jenkins.
Rod Harrington with me. You like the way that Steve Brown made his way up on stage, eh? Looks very relaxed, doesn't he?
He looks really relaxed, but he looks aggressive and confident. You know, he's already beaten Jenkins at the World Match Play, so he knows what he can do. He knows Jenkins is not really on the top of his game, and he won't get a better chance.
And today, that was pretty much his biggest victory, that win of the match play in Blackpool.
Yeah, certainly. Biggest match of his career, and it spurred him on. I like the way he looked against Jelle Klaassen, and he looks the same today. I mean, I expect him to play really well, and I think he could turn Terry over.
And what about Terry Jenkins' form? I mean, we know, very experienced Premier League player, 7 major finals he's been in, never quite won the big one though.
No, he's always come up against the Taylor and Wade, that's on brilliant form. We know what Jenkins can do. He does hit a lot of 140s, but his form over the last year, 18 months, has been very patchy. Against Joe Cullen, he went 2-0 up and then lost the plot a little bit in the next 2 sets. So if Brownie can get into him early, get in front and set his stall out, make Jenkins follow you.
Okay, Eric Bristow in commentary alongside Rod Studd.
Well, thanks, Dave. Terry Jenkins, as you said, 7 major finals without a major victory.
64.
And in peril here, you'd feel. Vulnerable to Steve Brown, who certainly looks the part. Can he deliver on the big stage? He beat Jenkins in the match play back in the summer, 10-6 in the 43. First round. Not Jelle Klaassen out in the first round here. Who's your pick, Eric? What do you fancy for this one?
I fancy Jenkins, to be quite honest. I mean, Jenkins 18 months ago was not playing too well, but about 6 months ago we was in Germany, played fantastic in Germany, lost in the semi-final to Phil Taylor, one of the best games I've seen, 11-10. So he's getting back to his form. And this lad's got a lot of pressure on him because he's played in 3 TV tournaments, the last 3 TV tournaments, got through the first round and fell at the second hurdle, yep. So he'd be thinking about that as well.
We saw you talking to Steve Brown earlier, sharing a cup of coffee. 96. What did you make of him?
I like him, he's a nice fella, yeah, he's a nice fella. And he'll do well, he's learning quick and he's hungry, and it's what the game needs, you know what I mean? Young blood in it, he puts the work in, that's what it's all about, and he loves the game.
Definitely a challenger for the title of second nicest bloke in darts behind you, Brissy.
A long way behind me as well.
95.
You won't win the most modest bloke in darts though, Brissy, will you?
But I've got you lost for words there just for a little while. And that's got to be worth some points, isn't it? You know what I mean?
47.
Not often you're lost for
no,
words.
No, not often. Well, Jenkins here on 188. And 140 would be nice to leave a 2 darter.
100.
Well, good third dart.
Just getting your arm going this first leg. It's lovely to win it, obviously, but it's just getting your arm going. That's a nice last start. That's 95. So he should get a shot at ball here, even if he misses the treble 20. Great first start. Double 14 for the first leg. Thank you very much.
Yeah, look, we finished with Terence Jenkins. It's the last 3 darts in that leg with 2 treble 20s and a double 14. And that will settle what any nerves were about for the Raging Bull. We saw a few in his first round game, mind, when he played Joe Cullen. He won the first 7 legs of the match. It looked like it was going to be over in about 20 minutes flat. And by the end, he'd really gone through the mincer.
He go asleep. So a few players have done that in this tournament so far. They get in front and they go asleep. I mean, Lloyd in his first round match, he was 2 sets and up, cruising. Everybody thought he was going to fly through, and he went asleep. And he was lucky to get through.
Jenkins eventually woke up in the final set against Cullen and won that relatively comfortably, but he was saying afterwards just what hard work he'd made of it.
60.
And this hasn't been the happiest of hunting grounds for Terry Jenkins. Reached round 3 last year, but that's the first time he'd won a match, beaten by Dennis Smith first round in 09 and by Kirk Shepherd, who'll forget that, in 08 when 100. Jenkins missed a bucket load of doubles for the match and Shepherd somehow got through.
And Shepherd had a good 2 years through that, getting to the final and had his chance really to turn pro, but he just over the 2 years wasn't good enough. I mean, he just got everybody beat him, and he had one good tournament.
But what a tournament it was, and who knows if someone like Steve Brown is going to come from nowhere from left field in a tournament like this.
43.
Well, this tournament changes people's lives, doesn't it? It's all about. When you get an opportunity, you've got to take it. That week, Kirk Shepherd, people missed doubles against him, and it wasn't his fault. Thank you very much. All right, there.
When there's £200,000 first prize, then it will change people's lives.
Well, it's a lucky tournament for him, really. When you think of that, he got to the final, And then he got a phone call like 10 days before it started because someone couldn't get a visa, and he got in it again. So is this the break to throw here? Big shot here. He's going to have double 10 here for another good finish. Oh, he's finishing lovely. That makes you feel good. He's had two darts at a double, finishing both first dart. Mr. Brown's in a bit of trouble here. Looks like he's going to lose the first set, and he's got to have a little bit of a break, get his head together, and the next set is his throw, and he's got to come out and win that set.
Yep. As you said, Eric, the two finishes from Terry Jenkins, 84 in two darts and 80 in two darts. Very clean.
That's right. 88 the first one was.
Sorry, Eric, 80.
That's all right, mate. No problem. 80.
So, threw that in to see if you were...
Well, I was awake. Yeah, I know, that's what it was. It's this book I'm reading. Here we go, first 180 of the match. There, he's playing lovely. Yeah, he is playing well.
Well, that's not bad either, is it, Steve Brown? Belting back with a maximum of his own. Mind you, this leg is still very much in Jenkins' control. Was he going to see that? Stay there! To lead double two.
Yeah,
I've seen that very often.
Yeah, I didn't think that was a sensible shot there. But the way he's hitting the doubles, he's at, you know, treble 16, I think double 8 would have been better on 64. But double two, he's hit the first half, both legs. All of a sudden, you could end up on double one, see?
Yeah. Well, that wire split there in the middle, isn't it, on double two? It makes no difference, and the inner wire of double two looks like it was split, but didn't stop Jenkins hitting it. And Jenkins has won all three legs with a minimum of fuss to romp to the first set. With an average of almost 105, Jenkins leads Steve Brown. 1-0.
Have a go. Everyone's got an opinion. What's yours worth?